up, guys? Welcome back to my channel. So for those of you who don't know me, my name is Brittany, and if you're new here, why don't you just go ahead and subscribe and give this video a thumbs up, because why not? Give this video a thumbs up because I'm about to show you my new intro in this video and you guys are gonna love it. So before I show you guys my new intro and, you know, the behind the scenes, have a little story time, I guess, about my dog Miko. So this is my dog Miko, for those of you who don't know. And as you can see, he does not have a haircut yet. Let me just explain to you guys what happened. I took him to the groomers 2 times and each time he did not get a haircut. You guys aren't gonna believe like what happened. Like, I'm just having really bad luck with getting my dog a haircut at time. So I'm gonna start with the first story. I took him to this groomer that I had been taking him to for like a year. They've always done pretty good, but they take their time. They kind of take a really long time actually, but not this long. So his appointment was at 11, and so I got there at 10:55, you know, 5 minutes early, and they took him and they said, okay, it's gonna be a couple hours. And I'm like, okay, bet. So I just like went and drove around. I went to a couple stores, just like killing time. And it's around 1:30, and I call them and I'm like, hey, is my dog done yet? Like, you know, it's already been over 2 hours. And they're like, oh yeah, it's gonna take another 2 hours. And I'm like, I even told them, I'm like, another 2 hours? And they're like, only thing we had time to do was to give him a bath. Like, we haven't had time to cut him yet. And I'm like, if his appointment was at 11 and you've had over 2 hours, I'm like, how do you not, like, I didn't say this, but I'm just like thinking, like, how did you not have time to like do everything by now? And they were just saying how they were like busy from like appointments earlier than his. So whenever they told me it was gonna be another 2 hours, I'm like, okay, whatever, like I'll just be patient, I'll just deal with it. Like, my dog needs a freaking haircut because it's summertime and it's freaking hot outside, and his hair is so thick. So by this time I'm waiting 4 hours, and then they said they would call me whenever he was done. And I never got a call. And so around 3 o'clock, instead of calling, I just go to the place and I walk inside and I'm like, hey, like, is my dog done? And they're like, oh no, it's gonna take another 2 hours. I'm like, what? I'm like, it's gonna take another 2 hours and you've already had 4 hours. I'm like, it does not take 6 hours to cut my 7-pound Pomeranian. Oh, I'm like, can I please just have my dog? But by the way, guys, I drove an hour there and an hour back and waited 4 hours when I was there. So I ended up wasting like 6 hours of my day just trying to get my dog a haircut, which he never got a haircut. And so they were like saying like, oh, let us make it up to you, let us make it up to you. I'm like, no, I'm like, I'm gonna find another place. So they brought me my dog and I watched the lady go get him out of the kennel, and I noticed that he had not been touched. Like, I could tell he had not even had a bath yet. So they lied to me and said he had a bath when he clearly did not. And then when I got him, he still smelled hella bad. He looked like what he looked like when I brought him in there. So I got even more mad because my dog was literally in a freaking kennel for 4 hours and no water. Anyway, so that happened. So I took him home and, you know, he just didn't get a haircut that day. So I go to another groomer and his appointment was at 9 o'clock in the morning. I thought it was weird because she didn't ask for my name. She didn't ask for Miko's name. She didn't ask any information. She just literally wrote down Pomeranian 9 o'clock. And I'm like, okay, like, whatever, I guess, you know. The other place wanted like his rabies shot, his like all his papers and like, you know, his name, my name. She didn't ask me any information, but I'm like, you know what? I'm gonna let the grooming do the talking. Anyway, so she said she would call me when she was done, and like probably in like 2 hours. And around 11:30, instead of calling, I just show up to the place. I walk into the groomers and this lady is laying down. She's laying down. I'm just like, and I'm like, are you okay? She was like, oh, I think I have food poisoning. And I'm like, oh, like, is my dog done? She's like, I didn't feel like cutting him. Like, I'm just so sick right now. And like, it's like, I get it. Like, we get sick, you know, food poisoning happens randomly. And it's just like I was trying to be understanding, but it's like, I've just been having so much bad luck getting my freaking dog a haircut. Only thing is, I wish she would have called me and not made me wait over 2 hours. I wish she would have called me and said, hey, I'm not feeling good, go ahead and pick up your dog. I drove 35 minutes there and 35 minutes back to this place, which is closer than the other place because the other groomers was an hour away. So yeah, those are my groomer stories that I wanted to tell you guys because I just thought that was so unfortunate to happen 2 times in a row. Let's hope the third time he gets a haircut. So before I show you guys my new intro, I'm gonna show you some behind the scenes of me and my friend Fred filming the intro in Miami. But I wanted to get the most out of my first intro that I could before I posted my second intro. You guys are finally gonna get to see it. Like, Miami was so much fun. I definitely wanna go back now since I am familiar with it. But anyways, he's like, so here's some clips of behind the scenes.
Banana pancakes for my problems. Find me jamming, old Jack Johnson. Swear I heard them angel calls. Lay outside as heaven falls. Heaven falls.
That makes me miss Miami. Guys, I want to travel so bad, and I haven't been able to travel anywhere because of COVID, and I'm just honestly over it. Now, Nico, can you please move? Can you please move? Well, now it's time to show you guys what you've all been waiting for, my new intro.
Okay, she giving me love, but it fucked my energy up. Every time it's finna be summer, only got the memories of us. And now we industry lovers, they making enemies of us. I mean, sometimes we in public, they dream this.
You know what? In case you like blinked and missed a part, let me show you that again. Roll the damn clip.
Okay, she giving me love, but it fucked my energy up. Every time it's finna be summer, only got the memories of us. And now we industry lovers, they making enemies of us. I mean, sometimes we in public, they dream this.
And there you have it. That's my new intro. That's what you're gonna be seeing at the beginning of my videos now. Say goodbye to my old intro. Bittersweet, I know. It just gives me like good summer Miami vibes. If you like my new intro, give this video a thumbs up. And I will see you guys in my next video. Mwah! Peace.